Of Optimistic Pride. Chapter 1, Fundraiser For The Win. It was a long day for Molly and her friends to finish the final episodes of the first season of her show, but even with so many takes, it was worth it. Including the long day to begin production on season 2, Disney Channel executives and writers would take the time they need to write episodes in the coming months. Molly McGee, along with her friends on set, Libby and Andrea, got out of the studio satisfied. "That took way longer than it should have taken," Andrea said, heading out the door. "How many facial expression classes did you take, Molly?" Libby added. "3, before I got the main role. You wouldn't believe how it felt when I got a call from the executives." Molly turned her head to her friends. "You didn't see in my audition videos? I got a call thanks to my commercials. I had less time looking at other auditions, okay?" Andrea replied. "And I only got in since they wanted a Jewish character for a change," Libby added. "If anything, I would have written the episodes instead of being part of them." The optimistic girl took months of auditioning with her friends before the show happened, and she only experienced pairing with them rather than knowing them personally. As they left the studio, she wondered what she could do to pass the time. "Seems like I've been focusing on our show than thinking about what cartoon stars do when they're on vacation. Have you known anything other than Amphibia and the Owl House?" "Mostly from Nickelodeon and Cartoon Network. They live farther away from where we live." "They're from different networks. What do you expect?" Andrea signed. "It's only once in a while where they can meet each other as long as the other network shows don't perform in a place like this." Molly and Libby took Andrea's words into consideration. Even as Disney Channel stars, they never met any other network stars in person, especially what they do once their shows take a hiatus or completely finish. When they headed down 3 blocks to Chandler Studios exit, they saw Allie and Jess from Amphibia putting a poster up on the wall. Usually, they would advertise the next episodes of the show, but once Molly saw the poster closely, it had nothing to do with her older sister's show on the network. "Hey, what are you pulling up?" She got the attention from Allie and Jess, who immediately turned after taping up the poster. "It's a fundraiser for our community," Allie added. "The Amphibia community?" Libby wondered. "Not really," Jess replied. "It's the LGBT cartoon community." Upon hearing the 4 letters, Molly became puzzled. Same goes to her friends. As Allie and Jess went past Libby and Andrea, Libby looked at the poster itself. "Wait, weren't you two, like, happy to be together on your last video post?" Molly follows the two. "We recorded that video yesterday, and just after we did the editing today, Allie stopped herself, causing her girlfriend to stop as well. It turns out that message the community sent us, that we're having a last-minute intervention." "A last-minute intervention?" Andrea added. "It's really private when it comes to this type of community," Jess replied. "Let's just say we need a bigger idea for people like us to come closer as a community." The two girlfriends left the newest Disney Channel stars as they headed to the car in the parking lot. Molly then turned her attention to the poster that Libby had been reading. "It looks like Allie and Jess's friends in this community need more help for the fundraiser," Libby said, with Molly and Andrea standing by her. "It says, stars and former stars in communities of far networks. We had to cancel our latest convention due to our budget receiving major cutbacks. Our last social media activities may get us success with our supporters, but we want this to be different, a project which hasn't been done before. but a showcase of how we support each other in this community. Not to mention, it would be interesting to have some new faces for the experience. If only we can have new inspiration from someone who know what it takes to make things bigger. After reading every single word from the poster, the three felt stunned, as if a community like this could end sooner than expected. The LGBT community is gonna split apart, Molly screamed. Do you even know what LGBT stands for? Andrea added. If you ask me, none of our show writers told us we're adding that to our show. Okay, maybe I don't know about the community, but it seems like it's about love, right? Molly said, making an awkward grin. I think there's more to love in this community. There's no hearts here, just rainbow colors, Libby noticed the poster's design. I expected something like this from you, Molly. When Molly looked at the six colors of the rainbow, it immediately gave her the bigger picture of the LGBT community situation. Maybe after I know everything about the LGBT community, I can come up with a fantastic idea to raise money for the fundraiser. Just as Molly celebrates in excitement, she completely sees Luce and Anime from the Owl House, who will be planning to go to Animal Kingdom. Hey Luce, Anime, she called to the two witches. Is there anything you need, Molly? Anime called back. You might want to take a look at this poster, she pointed at it. It didn't take long for Luce and Amity to head over to check the poster itself. Once they read the paragraph, they couldn't believe it at first. Was this poster just put up? Luce pointed. We saw Allie and Jess putting up posters, so... Yes, Libby answered. I think we should cancel our trip to Animal Kingdom and head straight to our community, Amity replied. Molly's eyes were shot open at the fact her Disney neighbors are familiar with the LGBT community. You're part of this? She leaned close to Luce. Well, technically since 2020, thanks to the fan base, but we've been taking this relationship to the next level since Season 2 started, Amity making an awkward smile. How am I getting the feeling none of your friends in that community warned you about financial problems? Andrea replied. We only met Applejack and Wilty along with a few. We never met all of the pairings in person, including Bonnabelle, Bubblegum, and Marceline. Seems like a bizarre relationship to me, Libby commented. Luce would make a head start with Amity for damage control on a budget crisis, but upon meeting Molly McGee for the first time, she witnessed her contributions in her very own show. And having creative independent freedom once shows go on hiatus, she wonders what she can do with all the spare time she has. Molly, I know you're not part of the LGBT community, but this is really important for me and Amity, Luce placed her hand on her shoulder. This may be an expensive job, but we can help out. We'll do anything you come up with. And don't forget, Amity pointed to Molly's friends, you may have an opportunity to surprise ours and your followers. When Molly looked at Libby and Andrea along with the poster behind them, she could make a difference even as a newcomer. You're right, Molly smiled. As long as I get everything I need to know about LGBT, they will live on until the end of time. Now that's the spirit, Luz hugging Molly in joy. Let's get to work. As she and Molly ran together to make the first step for the LGBT community to stay strong, Amity stands next to Molly's friends, watching Luce and Molly heading to her place to come up with a plan. Amity, Libby turned to Luce's girlfriend, is it okay that you tell me what relationships are in the LGBT community? You know, just for a heads up. Believe me when I say this. You would probably be accepting of pride representation, but not entirely wanting any part of it. Libby biting her lip. After watching Libby's performances in her best friend's show, She then whispered into her ear to give her the basics. Just when Libby was catching on, what Amity referred next stunned her, as if it was mostly about friendships, but it was more than that. When Amity backed away, Libby's eyes shot open and couldn't believe it, while Molly may think otherwise. Libby, Andrea looking at Libby, stood in place like a statue. All that Libby did was spaz in a bit, but she stuttered to speak with the idea that Molly could have mistaken her situation, knowing full well. I could tell you're not prepared to have a girlfriend anytime soon. Then Libby collapsed on the ground, unfazed from what she just heard. I stand corrected. Chapter 2, Options or Horses. Over the past hour since heading back to Luce's apartment, Luce helped Molly with the research on the LGBT cartoon community. She not only showed her the major articles on the LGBT website, but including the petition of the fundraiser that's yet to be available. Molly McGee searched harder than any other individual to come up with her original idea. Even by learning more about the cartoon stars old and new, she can tell they will be impressed in a community that got stronger by the year. After Luce got a text from Sam Sharp to meet them at one of the smallest theme parks that are closed during nighttime, she, Molly, and Amity flew with her hour staff, leaving Disney Channel Studios to head straight to their destination. The moon rose over the horizon while the sun slowly set. The theme park itself was closing momentarily with families and friends leaving. However, the only vehicles that remained parked were the stars of the LGBT cartoon community: Bonnabelle Bubblegum, Marceline, Ruby, Sapphire, Pearl, Bismuth, Adora, Catra, Luna Loud, Sam Sharp, Applejack, Rarity, Eden, and Red Action were waiting, some getting out of the cars to stretch and get some fresh air. Even if they had the time to go on a few rides in the theme park, they're not taking the risk of losing any more money than they already have. So, Jess and Allie are running late, huh? Enid asks, leaning against Red Action's hover tank. It seems they're too upset after the message we gave them, Red Action added. I don't blame them, Adora signed as she turned to Bonnabelle. Are you sure Luce and Amity are on their way here? They should be, judging that they're bringing a friend who I heard is new to the Disney Channel shows, Bonnabelle responded. You haven't even heard of her or her show? Paul wondered. We haven't been catching on Disney's latest shows, okay? We only watch Ephemia and the Owl House, Marceline added. You know, just because Disney Channel didn't have a better 2010s than Cartoon Network, they still knew what they were doing, unlike Nickelodeon, Ruby commented, only for Luna to take notice. No offense. I don't blame you or anyone, I blame our executives, Luna replied, leaning against a light post. Is it because the Cross of Gondis got cancelled? Applejack asked. Mostly. Soon enough, the theme park closed, with the small gates closing. Meanwhile, up in the sky, Luce is handling her hour staff with Molly and Amity sitting right behind her. It took longer for them to travel to one of the most peaceful theme parks in the nearby lands. Luce flew down to the parking lot, catching the attention of the LGBT community. We're here, Luce called as she and her friends got off of her staff. It didn't take long until they took notice of Molly McGee, the latest Disney Channel star. At first, they were expecting an old star with experience, but they always give newcomers the benefit of the doubt. This is Molly McGee, Amity introducing her as she waves with a smile on her face. She's gonna help us with the fundraiser. I got everything in my notebook, Molly showing off her notebook. Wait, before you show us your plan, we need to set things straight, Bonnabelle replied. The truth you need to know is we never watched your show, even with the promotions we've come across, Adora added. Molly knew at one point that some people won't recognize her right away, but it won't stop her from giving them an impression on her. To be honest, I didn't expect this day to happen, even for an emergency. Molly, darling, Rarity smiled. Expect the unexpected, even if it's not how we want it. But keep this in mind, if we don't succeed, you still have the opportunity to spend the time with us, Bismuth added. I've known some of you, just wish we would meet at your conventions, Molly responded. If anything, this intervention seems too unprepared, and this is a first to me. The community didn't like the last minute decisions at the wrong time, but on the other hand, if they knew what Molly's plan was ahead of time, they would make the last minute decisions right away. Let's get back on topic. What's your plan? Sapphire wondered. Upon listening to the gem, Molly opened her notebook and got to the pages she spent the past hours working on. My plan for the LGBT cartoon community to raise money for its fundraiser. She then raised her notebook in the air, showing what she drew to the community by riding horses in the outdoors. The picture itself is Molly riding a horse with its mane colored in the six colors of the rainbow. We just need to find the right amount of horses for all of us, dye their manes in colors you want, and then... She then took out an LGBT flag. We raised our flags while riding our horses. After witnessing the plan at first sight, they remained silent. They've been doing Olympics, vlogging at all kinds of conventions, and during their vacations, they show their passion before the pride of representation. However, they're always around people in return, and riding horses was the least interest they had. Well, what do you think? Molly squealed. Sam spoke. It's not a terrible idea, but did you think this through? Enid added. She had less than 2 hours. She can't just prove an idea for America, Luce retorted. We know, but you do realize we never rode a horse before, Luna added. I rode a horse during Steven Universe's production in season 5, Ruby smiled with sparkles in her eyes. It wasn't hard during rehearsals. Yeah, Ruby for the win! Molly hugged Ruby tightly. Molly, I don't think we're gonna work this out. Marceline walking up to Molly. For one, even if there's a chance we find horses, they're mostly uncorrelated. For two, the outdoors isn't exactly a place for anyone to hang out, Catra added, including tourists who spend most of their time in the studios to see creativity, Adora added. But this is creativity, Molly looking at her notebook. It's still not enough, Red Action replied. And for three, we need to plan out where we're going to make your plan work, Applejack added. If we did this in one of our worlds, we would only succeed in one community, which is not our community. If we really want our community to show representation, it has to be extraordinary, Sam finished. Everyone! Amity standing in front of Molly, who's feeling ashamed. Give her a break. I get it. We, except Ruby, never rode a horse, but having them part of our fundraiser could work in some other possible way. Yeah, we can hire a couple of people to control Allie and Jess's drones while we do our fundraiser, Luce smiled. Her friends in the LGBT cartoon community still had second thoughts, but they don't have any other option. Even if they go on hiatus, they could still be in this predicament for coming up with a plan. You really think this is gonna work? Bonnabelle placed her hand on her hip. We still need to find two more lesbian relationships. We're working on that. Molly pops her head behind Luce. Sapphire then had an idea, but she needed Ruby for assistance. She politely took Ruby's hand as the two fused into Garnet, surprising everyone, especially Molly, in complete shock. She took the notebook from Molly and looked at her plan. It may take days or weeks, butthole, but after years in knowledge of LGBT, she can see what Molly is up to. Possibilities are always endless. She looks straight at the horse Molly drew, but horses could be a turning point for all of us. Molly? Yes? Molly walked up to Garnet. The gem placed her hand on Molly's shoulder. I don't mind how long it would take, but time is always important. And to be honest, dyeing manes seems like a perfect style for showcasing our relationships. First thing in the morning, we're gonna start riding horses. Riding what now? Luna blinked, only for Garnet to turn around. We're not gonna get hurt. It's the horses that we're worrying about, Red Action commented. I haven't ridden a horse either, nor do my friends, and I know they're more careful when they're outside in the fields, Molly replied. Have your confidence put to the test of everything, Garnet turned her attention back to Molly. As for your friends, I'm sure they will be willing to guide you in your time of need. With confidence reaching to the max inside Molly McGee, she knows what to do tomorrow with the LGBT culture community, riding horses no matter how difficult it is. I've got everything under control. No, Molly, we got everything under control. Chapter 3, Xochi's Hidden Downtime. The dawn of the LGBT cartoon community's journey has begun. Molly McGee, her two friends Libby and Andrea, along with Ruby, Luna Loud, Applejack, and Marceline tagged along to go to the ranches where the horses are temporarily available. However, little did everyone know, Libby felt unfazed ever since she heard what Amity told her last night. She didn't even sleep properly last night, with the image so clear she wants to distance herself from it. But she doesn't want to disappoint Molly for how hard she's working. Here it is, Marceline pointed while wearing a huge hat to cover herself from the sun. I've heard that they have trained horses at this ranch, so it's an 80% chance we'll be safe from getting a concussion, Ruby commented. Do we get helmets like what people do on motorcycles? Libby wondered. They're called equestrian helmets, Applejack answered. If you really think you need more protection while riding a horse, then you don't know how it feels. I know what you mean, it's just I don't feel comfortable riding an animal that's bigger than me. Horses aren't cannibals, Libby, Molly wrapping her arm around her. They're really friendly once you see them. As the group headed inside the ranch, tons of animals of all kinds were inside the barn while one of the farmers were taking care of them. Luna called one of Lincoln's friends from the Loud House, Liam, last night to help them ride the horses. You do understand that Liam rides horses during his free time, right? Andrea asked. I've come across him several times, Ruby answered. He will help all of us, including the others. They witness horses of brown, black, and white running in laps around the ranch. Two of the three horses had Cheryl Romero riding on their own individual horse, but the one riding on the white horse had two people on. In a split second, Molly noticed there were two grown teenagers riding past her, but attention was cut short after seeing Liam standing by his horse. Liam, Luna called, I reckon you would bring company. Liam knows the LGBT community itself. Where are your other friends? They're doing more awareness stuff. They should be here in just under an hour, Ruby replied. And for the horses? Sorry, they're using them right now, he pointed at which caught Molly's attention again. Cheryl Romero got here 20 minutes before you did, and then two girls rode a horse together. Who are them? Molly wondered. Those Xochi and Ambella from Cartoon Network's Victor and Valentino, Marceline answered. While riding on the horses, Ambella's horse jumps over the fences displayed on the ground. Xochi is holding onto Umbrella, preventing herself from falling on the dirt. Are we almost done? Xochi asked. After passing the line 9 times, 10th is always the final lap. Umbrella cheered. After jumping the final fences in no time, they passed the line itself, resulting in Umbrella reining her horse. While Cheryl Romero went past them, Umbrella and Xochi got off the horse while the LGBT community took notice. They make it look so safe and easy, Luna commented. It takes lots of knowledge and practice to master this kind of thing, Applejack smiled. I think I know who these two are, Molly smiled. Molly, are you sure you know what you're doing? Libby spoke from behind. I've done my research. Besides, like Garnet said, we got everything under control. Molly made her way over to meet Xochi and Umbrella, all the while the group follows her. But Libby stood still, having no interest in meeting or helping at the moment. All except me, she signed. What do you mean? Liam asked, to which Libby turned her head. I'm not actually helping the community. I haven't told my friend about... Do you need advice? Yes. After Umbrella's horse went back to the barn, Umbrella stretched her arms. So where do you want to go today? She asked. Maybe we should check our schedules for the third season, so she taken off her equestrian helmet. I'm starting to get featured more than I thought. Then how about on social media? Molly grinned, catching their attention. Who are you? Umbrella replied. I'm Molly McGee, and I'm here to help the LGBT community. Despite the high adrenaline in her system, both Xochi and Umbrella became confused. One more time. Wait, did you just say LGBT, lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender? Xochi placed her hand on her hip. Yeah, sorry to interrupt your time, but we're trying to organize a fundraiser, Ruby said. We somewhat took Molly's advice to ride horses in the open fields, all the while capturing what we need and posting it on social media, Marceline added. So she had dealt with fundraisers when she helped out. But being part of one to catch people's attention is the last thing she thought. Did all of you just got here or something? So she catching on. You should be familiar with me and Ruby. I know, but everybody else, I wasn't expecting a crossover community. Also, we're only here to have some downtime. How will this fundraiser do any favors for us? Umbrella crossed her arms. Because, Molly grinned, you would get more recognition on social media. Upon hearing the idea, Xochi still didn't give in to the idea. In fact, it only made her think otherwise. In case you have noticed, our show isn't as popular as other Cartoon Network shows. If you ask me, building a fan base is enough for me to care. The LGBT community wouldn't expect that reaction from time to time, but nearly all of them had never watched Victor and Valentina before. You barely do much on your show, huh? Andrea commented. I'm not the main character, believe me, there's less to what a character does when fan service doesn't happen. It's true, Umbrella added. Applejack turned around at Cheryl Romero, who are still riding the horses. Knowing that Xochi and Umbrella both shared a horse together, she refuses to let any relationship go, with it becoming harder and harder to come across. You can still succeed by growing a fan base. Yeah, like, you two are aware that you're both in an LGBT representation discussion, Ruby smiled. I'm not sure if people on social media would watch your show when it comes to the main stars, but they would still acknowledge you two. Trust us, This will make both of your careers quite a bit better, Marceline added. Xochi and Umbrella both will realize that if they don't accept this opportunity, they won't do much as supporting characters after Victor and Valentino eventually comes to an end. The more they think about it, they would mostly spend their time together as has-beens rather than people being remembered by fans. Success could only mean something when they wanted it, even when it's deserved. And that's what they're going for. Are you sure your fundraiser will work? Xochi replied. We're in a budget crisis, dude, Luna said. It's either now or never. Okay, we're joining your fundraiser. Great, we'll take care of everything, Molly squealed as she shook Xochi's hand. You won't regret this. As far as I'm concerned, I was expecting a dramatic chapter to happen in our fundraiser. And Bella finished. Molly? Luna looked around the group. Where's your dude, Libby? When Molly McGee took notice, Libby was nowhere in sight. Soon the rest of the group looked around to find Molly's Jewish friend, calling out her name, but she didn't pop out or respond to the calls. We are the nowhere generation!